in their land.
The
motor doesn't rotate either. And you said last time that the one jumping is capable of moving for about 15 meters. Does this 15 meter include the bounding? So it is like a long jump of a truck and run. So jumping and then the first landing is like a 15 meter away from the jumping point. But with the bounding, they can go a little bit backward. So we believe that the initial moving distance is the 15 meter with the jumping. And so with the speed and the gravity, we have calculated that this will be the estimate. Thank you.
Any other questions?
Documentary Japan の山本です。
Documentary Japan, Yamamoto speaking.
された久保田先生ならではの
Professor Akubuto of Experience Hayabusa 1, I'm sure you have these special feelings to Minerva
21.
So can you share with us your frank or honest feelings?
Well,
the Hayabusa 1, we had one Minerva mounted to it. There were various defects, and during the rehearsal, we had to separate Minerva during rehearsal. At that time, we separated by the command from Earth. But above 30 minutes, remote control is very difficult, is what I have experienced. So having this second opportunity as the engineering researcher, I'm very happy and I'm very fortunate, is what I think.
This
time, there are many planet activities, so it's not just one, so we are going to have two mounted, and we are taking on challenges of various possibilities. So it took time, but being able to have this challenge once again, I'm very pleased, and based on the various experiences that I have had till now, I am devising many things, so I hope that it will go well. If I can get even one picture of the asteroid, I'll be very, very happy. Thank you very much.
中野さん、そちらの方へお願いします。
あ、すみません、フリーランスの大塚です。
大塚、フリーランスジャーナリスト。
最初にちょっとお話が出たライダーにですけれども、前回の立ち
down some words about the lighter and then the last time at the time of the touchdown rehearsal the switching from the long distance mode to near distance mode, short distance mode, was that automatically switching
どちらに、
or was that predetermined in terms of a predefined altitude? Well, optical sensor, in order for high accuracy of measurement, they need to have a certain volume of light. Otherwise, they cannot judge that the measurements are accurate. So when there is an enough amount of light from long distance mode, remote mode to near mode, that the switching takes place. That was the setup. And more than expected, there was a less amount of light, so that's the reason why switching didn't take place. So the altitude was not predefined, just to double check. Well, near mode is not determined based on the altitude. It is the intensity of the light. When it's enough, it switches to near mode. LiDAR, on the other hand, is doing a measurement constantly from a 20 meter altitude, and in order to keep the accuracy, we will go to up to 600 meters. After that, then the accuracy is not sufficient, and it was not that fast, so it came back. And this time we changed the parameters in the course of the way, so that they can continue measurement. LiDAR is capable of doing measurements from 20 meters to 10 or so meters, and as far as Ryugu is concerned, we believe that in the remote mode they can go up to 100 meters or so. However, to take a safe side, up to 600 meters, it's a remote mode we defined that way, and we thought that it will switch to a near mode in the course of the way. And then gravity measurement, and it went to 850 meters, and we used that and we applied some margin to come up with the setup. However, this time the landing site was the site was too dark, or it was on such an inclination which prevented from the light to be applied. So at 150 meters down, will it really switch to near mode? We have to try it out to see, but to take safe side, and we are taking a safest side and doing this time. So if it so just happens that the light is applied to a very dark place, it may not switch to near mode. But if a reflection rate is high, it's more there is high intensity, then it may switch to near mode at a higher point than 150 meters. We have to try. So if it cannot switch to near mode, then once again this time you would have to do the abort before release. Instead of separation. Yes, if it doesn't switch to near mode, then we have to do that. Or another point, ONCT, you said that the sight is quite limited, but the W can be quite capable of taking images, is that right? Well, after separation, a certain a number of images were taken before moving on to W1. So we believe that W1 will be higher certainly than T. Well, thank you.
フリーランスの秋山です。
秋山フリーランス、
2点ちょっとご確認。
I wanted to confirm two points. First of all,
降下中のハヤブサ
descending,
撮った写真、
the Hayabusa 2,
これは薄田局
the photos that Hayabusa 2 took,
ものなのでしょうか。
はい、
can you actually
薄田局で運用
を今ますけど、deliver it to Usuda Station. Well, right now Usuda Station is working on it, but the time is kind of close, so it might be overseas. So it may come down to Usuda Station. Well, the sequence this time is a timeline. It's not controlled by time, but from a certain point, it will be the distance from the surface, meaning the Hayabusa itself will look at it. So we can estimate a certain time of the separation, but it will be determined by altitude, meaning that the gravity of the asteroid distribution will determine that. So there is a certain wide time range. Therefore, if we take a broad range of time that they may happen, then the data may arrive later than what we expect. Okay, understood. The second point is that the success of the hop, meaning that whether the hop was done or not, of course, if you look at the photos, you can confirm. But is there any factors that you can confirm that the hop was success? What would you use? Well, this time, Minerva 2's purpose is to check the movement mechanism, but as a Hayabusa project at Hayabusa 1, we were not able to land it. Therefore, Minerva 2, having it landed to the asteroid surface is the first purpose. There is Minerva 2, there is Mascot. So if either one of them can land on the surface, then Hayabusa 2 means that it established technology for separation. And of course, Minerva 2 landing is important, but also the movement mechanism is important too. So the photographs taken when it landed and the photos after a certain time passes, if it is a different scenery, you will know that it's different. Because if the Minerva doesn't move and just stay static, it will be the same photo. But if it's a different scenery, you can tell that it hopped. And if Minerva can take several photos while they're moved, then we will know in what way, in what path it hopped. So we will be able to estimate to a certain extent of the distance it hopped. But if it's only one image, it's difficult to do so. But this is just a pure estimation. But if we are able to at least have two photos and it's a different scenery, then it will be a proof that Minerva for sure hopped. So basically, it will be a confirmation by photos or images. Yes. And the status that the motor moved, I will be able to take that data also. So even though the camera could not take the image and photos, the information of that, the motor, and also after a certain time, using the photodiode, we will know the direction of the sun. And if the direction of the sun data change, then that means that Minerva itself has moved. So, of course, number one is photos and images, but
we
will know after the motor moved, the value of the photodiode diode will know, and the gyro is mounted too. So with the data of that gyro, it will be a proof that evidence that it moved. Thank you.
一番前の方にマイクをお願いします。
あ、すみません、ライターの荒船です。ちょっとあの60メートルの行
動。もう一回。見てから60メートル、
見てからの。
So once they approach 60 meters, they move in northern direction. And then with that after that, they do the free fall or in parallel going northward. Well, N6 site is on the.Page 16.
N6 の赤道
of the deck. So N6 is slightly in the north of equator. So the fall is a point toward the equator. And when the altitude is 50 or 60 meters, there will be a jet injection to the upside of this map.
遠くぐらいに行った時に降ろすことになりますから、もし小惑星表面にいたとすると、 N6 に人がいたとすると、 そういうステータスデータと画像データを、探査機経由で、地上に降ろすということになります。
どうもありがとうございます。
ドライターの林と申します。基本的なことをちょっとお伺いしたいんですけれども、先ほど15メートルぐらいミネルバ2がジャンプするだろうということなんですが、どのくらいの高さを飛んだかということはどうやってわかるんですか。
はい、いや大変いい質問というか難しい質問なんですけども、ジャンプをして途中で写真を撮ることを考えているんですね。で、写真を撮って特徴点があるとですね、
And if they have a point that they reach,
わかります。それで着地するまでに数枚撮れるとどんな軌道を描いたかっていうのがわかるんですけども、距離情報っていうのは1枚の画像でなかなか難しいんですけど、同じ場所がもしかすると
It's difficult. But if they can take multiple photos, so we will know.
ある意味撮れるかどうかわかりませんけども
。From the changes of scenery.
撮れるとすると。
But if it can take its own shadow, then from the area size of the shadow, we'll be able to know what the altitude is. Though the accuracy may not be that precise, but we will know the rough.
精度がいいんですけども。
Image. If we can take photos.
精度の予測はできる。
A lot of photos, so it will become more accurate. But it's several photos, it will still be able to be known. So the photo or images will become a very important aspect. Yes. And also the light intensity or gyro status data, or the departure time and arrival time. If we can take that by the accelerometer, we will know that it hopped or jumped.This distance. So this a photo or image. At what timing it will be taken? It is actually embedded inside Minerva. Yes, all of it will be decided and thought by Minerva.
一番は電力ですね。
So number one is the power and temperature control. They will think.
どれかというのは自分で。
They will think about that and to make a decision of how many photos itself can take. Well, it's all programmed. So within the program, is it already embedded that when it hops, how many photos to take? Well, when it jumps, the power amount and also the.
をどのぐらい速く回すかによりますので、その速く回す速度に応じて
height or the speed they will know and also depending on the speed and distance we will know if it's closer or far away. If it's closer it will take more photos, farther away less. So looking at all these data comprehensively, Minerva will make the decision. So Minerva on above Ryugu, in what path did it take and move?
できればそうしたいんですけども、
If possible, we'd like to do it, but if it's not overlapped, it will be difficult. So I cannot say that we can do it, but we will put our efforts into do it, meaning that this is the landing point of Minerva and what kind of movement it made. If we can know about that, that will be great, but with limited data, we cannot tell you to what extent we'll be able to know about it. And I'm sorry to ask this question now.
移動するロボットっていうのはこのミネルヴァが世界
But the robot that it will actually move around the small celestial body is the first in the world.
ホッピング型のロボットを
Astronaut around Mars, the former Soviet Union rover was launched up there and separated, but we do not know what happened to it. And right now, recently, Rosetta mission Fidelity.
どちらかというと機能を持ってなかったので、まあ、ローバーというよりもランダーに
近い。So it's more of London than a rover. So the movement mechanism varies.
っていうのがありますけど、実際に
We challenge with Hovolos, but at the small celestial body hopping never has occurred, especially with the mounted motor rover. I think it will be the first in the world.To the general public, the greatness of Minerva. What areas would you like the general public to focus on? It's only a 1 kilogram rover, but it operates with the solar power. It has a motor. It also has a computer mounted, and they have 3 or 4 units of camera mounted. So it is actually a concentration of all of the Japanese technology. It's only kind.And it is operating 300 million kilometers away from Earth. Think on its own, similar to artificial intelligence. And if it succeeds in doing the things it has to, then you'll know the greatness of the Japanese technology and capability, especially the younger generation. I'd like them to watch this. Thank you.
G-Tsushin の神田です。
Kanda from GG Press.Earlier today, you said that after landing, it will be shortly evening, 1.5 hours or so later after landing, it will be a night time. But then, presumably after the initial landing, before the start of the evening, there will be at least initial hopping?
重力によるんです。
Well, depends on the gravity of the touched landing site. There will be the first contact within 30 minutes or so initially, and then we can really not predict. But we don't think it will stop immediately. It takes some tens of minutes, so it will be in total 1 hour. So for the rest of the remaining 30 hours, if they can take initial pictures, they will be able to send them. So that's really depend on how lucky they are. So hopefully they will get a good rest during the night time with sleep and to take pictures on the following day. And so it's at the 7.6 hours rotation, so 4 hours daytime, 4 hours night time. And then separations from the space craft and Minerva will switch to autonomous mode. Switching to autonomy mode. Will be based on the telemetry between through the communication between Hayabusa 2 and rovers. Well, rovers themselves, Minerva 2, when it receives a separation command in a dark box, triggers the solar power mode. Then detecting that, the Minerva knows that Minerva has to switch to autonomy mode. So we are just monitoring that with telemetry. And it's a status rather than a data recorder. So we will be able to get the information relatively fast. So we, if the Minerva gets separated, we can see that quite immediately. So when the separation is confirmed on the ground, from Hayabusa 2, the separation can be confirmed in 17 or 18 minutes later. But when Minerva is switched to autonomy mode, can it be sent as an information to the spacecraft after separation? Well, during the separation, and then the signals can come. So through Minerva, from Minerva, through relay equipment and to the ground. Can we think that there is little time lag? Very small time lag. And then, so when you receive those signals, you judge immediately that the separation took place, actually. Is that right? Yes, I think so. Thank you.
Nakayama from Mainichi Newspaper. It will be another basic question, but when the separation happens, the speed of that in the first Hayabusa Minerva, it actually went above the release speed. So if the speed is, sorry, if the how would you know that the release happened at the estimated speed? The separation speed, how much that was, it's difficult to actually obtain, because the speed is determined on the trial here on Earth, and we use the German facility, Boeing, and calculated it. But the speed that Hayabusa has, of course, we calculate that jet injection happens, and then it accelerates, and we know the speed of that. But whether Minerva will be that speed or not, we do not know. So there is a certain range. But even though there's a certain range, the Minerva being able to land safely will be controlled by Hayabusa. The reason why the speed was above what we estimated, Hayabusa knew its speed, but regardless of that, it received the command to separate. But this time, such a thing will not happen. But the actual separation speed, we will not know. The position of first contact, or the after point,
the
post-analysis is difficult, but I just hope that they separate within the speed that we estimated. So whether it will be able to separate...
これもなかなか難しくて、実際のところミネルバ2をどのぐらいの速度で分離したかっていうのは、これは通信しながら見ていくしかないので、すぐにはちょっと言えないかと思います。 ただあの着地した要するにフォトダイオードが一定の値になったっていうことからこれは小惑星表面にいるんだろうということと写真が撮れればこれがあの絶対的なあの証拠になるかなとは思います。
そうしますとじゃあ分離については先ほどの質問のお答えのようにおそらく瞬時に分かると、
はい、あの決められた高度で決めた、はい、ハヤブサ2の速度で分離したっていうのはすぐに分かるので、はい、分離はできたっていうのはそこで分かると思います、はい、
でそれがおそらくいい分離であったかどうかっていうのはその時点ではなかなか言い難い
言い難いと思いますね、はい
はい、それとあとあの写真を撮影したものをこう戻す流れなんですけれどもミネルバが撮ってで、それはすぐにこう、ハヤブサに向かって送り始めるんでしたっけ。なんか何枚か貯めてから送るんです。
はい、これはあのいろんなケースがあるんですけども、一つはですね、あの何も写ってない画像を送るっていうのは無駄になりますので、まず写真を撮りましたら、これをまずミネルバ2のメモリーに入れるかどうかっていうのを判断するロジックが働きます。そこで選別をして、これは良さそうだなっていうのをメモリーに貯めて、で撮動終わった後に電力を見ながら、通信するっていうことなので1枚だけ送る場合もありますし数枚まとめて送る場合もありますが、まあ、時間が経つほど電力も厳しくなりますのでなるべく早く送るようにはプログラムしてます。
その場合あのその通信速度なんですけれどもあの普通に例えば静止画でその写真を撮った場合に、ミネルバからハヤブサの中継機に行くのにどれぐらい1枚あたり時間がかかると見ていらっしゃいますか。
はい、これあのどのぐらいの画像が撮れるかによりましてこれ圧縮かけますので小さくなった場合には割と早いんですけどもで今の最大 32kbps という速度ですから1秒間に 32kb ですから4キロバイトのデータを送れるんですが実はこれあの最大速度でありましてミネルバ2台ありますのでこれはあのシェアします。ですから実際の速度はもっと遅くなりますので多分 10kbps ぐらいの速度で送ってその画像がまあどのぐらいかで4キロバイトであれば1秒で送れますしもう少し大きくなるとそれだけ時間がかかるということになります。
わかりました、ありがとうございます。
日本放送は畑中と申しますがちょっと基本的なことで恐縮なんですけど、はい、こちらです。あのミネルバがあの着地する時の衝撃ってどんな感じでしょうか。あの微小重力なんですが、はい、CG 見るとそれなりの当たり方もしてるんでちょっと気になるんです
けど、はいはい、あの聞かれると思ってちょっと用意してたんですけど用意してたペンなんですけどあのだいたい分離速度がだいたい20センチ秒速20センチぐらいかなと思っておりましてただこれキャンセルするので速度はあの効果方向速度は多分数センチパーセックぐらいかなと思うんですね。でこれ地球上に直すとですねもうこのぐらいなんですね。速度として地球上に直しますともうこのぐらいから落とすぐらいの衝撃ですからまず壊れないかなとは思ってます。あのこんな高くではなくてですねもう数センチパックっていうのは本当このぐらいからポンと落とすぐらいに触るので本当ちょっと触るっていう感じなんですけどもあのこの前質問がありましたようにその時にこうピンが出てたりして、まあ、帯電の状態によっては放電が起きるとですねこう接触するとこう近づくとですねこう雷のようにビッて来た時に、まあ、回路をやられないかなというのは前々からこれは心配はしてたんですけども、まあ、分離物をやるっていうのはもうこれ致し方ないところでいろんな策を取ったとしてもなかなか難しい分かりませんけど構造的に壊れるっていうことは本当には触ったって感じですよね。このぐらいからポンと落とすぐらいのこのぐらいの距離しかあの衝撃は加わりません。
ちなみにあの参考までにどれぐらいの衝撃まで耐えられるように設計されてるんですかね。みんな
これはですねあの一番厳しいのはロケット打ち上げ時の衝撃で、まあ、ロケットの打ち上げの G に耐えられたぐらいですからあのかなり大きいあの高いところから落としても多分あのへこむかもしれませんけど、壊れないようには作っています。
わかりました。
何百 G とか、そのぐらいの重力はかかります、かかってると思います。
それから物理的な衝撃はそういうことなんですけど、はい、なんかのその機器のそのまあ先ほどその帯電の可能性もあるというそういうものはまた別次元の話になる、
ね、そうですね、はい。あとあの心配しているのはあのまあ最初にこう置いた時にこう尖った岩に当たるとですね太陽電池に傷がつく。で気圧がつくと全損かというとそうではなくて電力が得るのが少し減っていくという形です。ただそれがこうどんどん飛んでいくとまあ傷がついたりあるいは砂がもしあって静電気でくっつくと発電量はどんどん下がっていくのでどんどん下がっていくかもしれませんけどあの 多少の傷では動作できるようには考えては作ってあります。
ありがとうございました。
NVS の斉藤です。リュウグウの基本的な物理のちょっと条件を教えてほしいんですが、リュウグウでの地表面での脱出速度って大体どのぐらいになるんでしょうか。
これ多分場所によると思うんですけど、大体40センチ50センチぐらいかなと。ですから一応倍は安全には見てはいるんですけど、できるだけ速度は小さくしたいなということで、大体場所にもよりますが、大体40、35とか40ぐらいかなと思ってます。
と大丈夫だと思うんですが、ミネルバがフルでホッピングしたときはその速度は超えないですよね。
これすごい大事な点なので、分離する前にこれ以上飛ぶなと、リュウグウの重力を教えてますので、それはないです。
わかりました、ありがとうございます。
吉川も登場しておりますので、どちら久保田もしくは吉川という指名をしていただいて質問していただいても構いません。質問がある方挙手をお願いいたします。
ライターの林です。たびたびすいません。ミネルバが降りる場所で、写真を撮るということなんですけれども、科学的な観点からそこでの注目点というのがあれば教えてください。
はい、では吉川の方からお答えしますけれども、やはり一番 のサイエンス的な注目は、表面すれすれで至近距離で写真が撮れるということですね。当然探査機本体からもですね、探査機が接近をしたときにかなり近い距離で写真撮りますけれど、本当に表面に降りた状態で例えば表面を横方向から写真を撮るということは探査機にはできませんから、表面 石ころとかですね、あるいはレゴリスの様子がより正確に分かるということで、これ非常に科学的には期待しているところです。
この N6 という場所の何か特徴みたいなのはあるんでしょうか。
はい、基本的にはですね、今回のリュウグウというのはあまり表面上に大きな違いはないということで、逆に言うと、
It's quite homogeneous.
大きな。
Which means that whichever is the landing site, then the data will not be significantly different. However, space available touchdown site for spacecraft and respectively for Minerva and for Mascot, we have decided a location with a certain distance from each other. So if we can able to obtain data from all of them, we will be able to have quite a comprehensive information about the asteroid as a whole.
他はいかがでしょうか。
Any other questions?
予定を、
I would like to explain the schedule moving forward. Right now in Japanese time from 1 p.m. to 1:30 p.m. Between that time there the separation will occur. So we are going to the control room also. And after that, on an appropriate basis, we would like to give you the report. I don't know about the exact time, but around 2 p.m. 1400 hours will be around that time. I wanted to explain this.
すいません。
But I ran out of time, so I'd like to explain about it later. I was wondering how long you're going to hide it, and now again we have to wait for the next opportunity. It's not that we are hiding it from you, but as scheduled, it is descending. So the explorer itself is operating normally, is what Professor Yoshikawa said. So we would like to leave this room for a while. Thank you very much.Thank you very much.
時間をこれで終了。
With this, I would like to conclude the explanation session. Maybe the time may differ, but around Japan time, 2 p.m., we would like to conduct another briefing session.